Chad, what is the one road story that Brian would be most embarrassed if you told right now?
In Indonesia?
Oh no. We
you
know
told
what?
That one.
Hold
I'm pretty
on.
Sure.
I told my half of that
oh,
one.
Oh man.
I feel like finally we need to get the other side of the story because there were two stories that happened in parallel. You've already heard Brian's adventure.
You need to play these tracks in parallel.
One ear on one side, yes. One ear on the other.
Completely unintelligible, but you just need to do it.
All right, so the last album, Night Attack 2, Brian told a story about going to Indonesia and having a very, very friendly exchange. Friendly. It's called Special Massage. Go ahead and listen to it.
Yes.
Chad, we now return.
We now return to Indonesia.
This is the Ender Shadow of parallel novels.
I am Bean and you are Ender. Absolutely.
Okay, so I go in. We're like, hey, bro, we're in a foreign land. Yes. Let's get a massage. They're only $30
for
an hour-long massage. Before you even go in, what does it mean for you to prepare your mind? Where is your head at?
I knew if I was going to do this, it was kind of like getting a tattoo for the first time.
Right.
Where I'm going to go all the way. Like, I'm not going to get like some crappy, tiny, like, I'm just going to do it. Like,
yeah, sure.
And I was really nervous about, like, I've heard that, you know, you get naked for it. And like, I was nervous about that.
Sure.
I think my age was either 21 or 22. So at least 3 or 4 years ago. Here's the epitome of what I'm getting at. I'm sharing this moment with you and the people who have bought this album. Is I was still a virgin at this point. Okay.
Oh, shit.
So getting naked, even if there was a towel in between me and another person, was a big deal to me.
By the way,
it had
for
not
the record,
happened yet.
I did not get naked because I was not comfortable doing it. So I wore my underwear.
I was in my head games. I overthink things. I was like, I'm gonna do this for real. So that was the head game. You ask, and so that was it. So we go up.
Okay,
hold on.
Let's. Is this the furthest? If you were to get naked and have somebody rub on you, is this the furthest that you had gone sexually? Up to that point.
Yes. Yes. With the point of view that this was going to be platonic.
Sure.
Sure.
The professional, right? So we agree that we're going to do this massage. We go up. We agree on the price or whatever. We go into the room. The room is gorgeous. It has rocks all in the corners. There's this wonderful table. I guess I awkwardly stand there for a little while until the lady comes in and says, you know, you can change in this towel or whatever.
Go into a bathroom. It's really nice.
So I get completely naked, change into a towel. And walk out, and she's walking me through it, and I get on the table or whatever.
And now you're like, yeah, like this.
I'm
is,
like,
this is what you do, Chad.
Right.
Oh yeah, let me get that massage.
I was naked as hell. I was really nervous. And I was like, I'm kind of conquering this small fear, but you know what? I know that everyone who ever talks about massage, and I had friends who were massage therapists and stuff. And they were all pros. And I was like, yeah, I'm just really nervous. And it's just like, it just seems really awkward. You know, like a human, like rubbing another human is a little bit sensual. And like, I just don't want it. And they're like, oh,
it's
no,
intimate.
It's
yeah.
Super professional. Like nothing's ever going to happen. And so I was like, okay, I'll do it. Like, and on top of that, like, I was like, if I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it right. I'm not going to be the guy that goes in there with his underwear on that makes it super weird, like
this guy,
hard
right
to get
here.
Into, right?
No, I hear you. That's all right.
So I lay down on the table and the massage starts and, you know, it starts on the back or whatever.
As the massage goes, your anxiety and nervousness, does it melt away?
No.
Or does it heighten?
No.
Okay.
No, well, it's about the same until... Go ahead.
No, brush well, I was about see. To say, this is exactly my parallel experience when I described, because like, I was worried about, like,
ready.
I'm going to have to roll over, and then it'll be a thing. All right, and so what? Tell me, first of all, for the record, you heard me describe my massage therapist as a mid-50s-year-old woman.
Oh, yes.
Whereas...
Here's the other thing.
Chad got this, like, mid-20s.
Yes! She was, like, 25, 28. Okay?
Pretty?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And so this is the other thing. So as she's doing the massage, I forgot about this. I'm so glad you said this. Is I am trying, like, I'm trying to alleviate the stress that I'm feeling. And the way to do that is to ask her about her life. So I ask her, I'm like, so how long have you been doing this? And she's answering in okay English. Like, it's broken, but it's okay. She's like, oh, you know, like, you know, 6-7 years, or, you know, something like that. And I was like, wow, like, since, like, she was like 18 or something like that. And then I'm like, you know, so where do you live? And she just totally brushed off that question.
Right.
She was like, she lives in the slums. I can tell, you know, and like, right. And so, and I'm like, you know, do you have any family members? And she's talking about her family.
Jesus, James Lipton.
No, like, seriously. This.
What's this, your favorite curse
this
word?
This will come back to haunt me. Haunt me forever that I ask these questions. So, and that's like during like the back massage or the arm massage or whatever. And then she gets to the legs, and the moment she gets to the legs, her fingers go towards, oh, and like on the back, she's still, it's still like, it's in that area, but I'm like, maybe this is what they do, right? Once she gets to the legs, it goes in areas.
It goes the sales pitch.
Oh my gosh.
She starts the sales pitch.
And this is, I want to preface the point of time that this is in. My mind needs to block this out, what is happening. And do you know what my mind plays over and over and over? Her fingers, but just to paint the story, right?
Sure.
Her fingers go into areas that I don't know if I've caressed. Yes. in like months or years, right?
Sure.
So
we're talking taint territory.
Taint territory is absolutely where we're at. Okay.
Yeah. So she's given. Yeah, she's given a little. Lying. How's your father to the taint?
I'm glad I'm lying face down.
Sure.
At this point, right? And my mind, I will. This always is super associated with this massage. I was trying to think of anything to lessen the pressure
before you go. Okay. Can I confess something?
Yes.
That, you know, you hear the cliche is thinking about baseball stats or whatever.
Right. Or grandma's like, sure, dancing.
Yep. For me, it has always been to name as many graphics cards as I can remember.
Okay.
I remember the NVIDIA TNT, the TNT 2.
I have one better for you.
All right.
Because this is exactly where my mind went.
Okay. And this is all to basically keep everything in check.
Keep everything in check.
Right.
Was literally, and this is very specific to the point of time of year that this was baby monkey, baby monkey, riding on a pig, baby monkey. It was, I played over and over in my head, baby monkey riding on a pig backwards, baby monkey. It was, that was the only thing I could think of through this entire experience. Burned like just burned into this experience is baby
so
monkey
your,
riding on
your
a pig
brain
baby.
your brain does not go into, hey, I need to stop this, hey, I need to communicate
no,
that I'm feeling
no no no, 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 no,
it shuts down. It shuts down.
The thing that I latched onto to stop this.
To get yourself into a headspace away from what was actually happening.
Yes.
Is you think to yourself, the world has gone insane and you don't know what is right.
Right.
You just got to keep on keeping on. Hold on to that pig.
And hold on tight.
Yeah. No, okay.
Absolutely. Over and over and over again, baby monkey riding on a pig backwards, baby monkey.
Okay.
Now, how long would you estimate that happened, that you were singing the baby monkey
the
song?
The whole 60 minutes.
Dude, and by the way,
the
I don't even remember. I guarantee you.
So she goes right to your nuts? Like, it goes
basically,
like,
yes.
Hey, 5 minutes on the shoulders, yes. 5 minutes on the lower back, 5 seconds on the legs. Merp. Like, she's like,
no,
right,
so,
up in your shit.
So here's the thing. After she hits the legs and that happens, you're like, where the hell is this going to go next? So even if she's, you know, massaging your feet or whatever, you're just like, how do I deal with this? Because you're already primed.
Okay. All right. So let's.
And then
let's,
what
let's,
happens
let's
when
talk.
You turn over?
Let's
what
talk.
The, what God, like
this is so parallel. I'm so glad we're having this conversation.
Right.
Okay. So as a percentage. In your mind, how chubbed up are you at this point?
It's 70%.
Wow. So you're laying face down.
Yes.
And by the way, Justin,
which at that point, listen, man, when you are guessing 70, it could be 100.
Yeah. Like, you know, as we found out from the last track of this ilk. Yes.
Yeah. Right.
So what next?
So, okay. So she does that and I'm just replaying my head, all this stuff.
Baby
and then
monkey.
What I was also replaying my head is her family story that I asked about in the first 5 minutes. And I'm like, why does she do this? Why? What horrible place are we in that...
So now you're just in this bizarre remix of like, baby monkey, my father was a fisherman.
Yes!
Baby monkey, I would like to go to college riding backwards on a big baby
Absolutely.
Monkey. I hope my children live a better life than I.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And then, I mean, you can basically fast forward through the rest of it of I have to flip over. Super, super awkward experience where...
Okay, now the big reveal. Okay,
the thing I could not...
Yeah, don't rush through this, Chad. There's some people stroking it to me.
Oh, my gosh.
Real quick. For those who listened to volume one of this tale,
right,
there was a place where I thought I was 40% chubbed, and it turned out that I was full on rigid and weeping when I turned over. Like, did you have a similar surprise?
I turned over... And I mean, I think I was at 70% the whole time because it was moving the towel that she had, but also she would move the towel to get at like your upper thigh.
Sure.
And I swear I was like, are you taking a peek? Like it was lifting off. I could feel the towel leaving the groin area. I was like,
wait, hold on. Are you aware? That I feel like I'm very accusatory of that. Like, sir, are you aware that like that there is a reputation to these kinds of places? That like if you go to Indonesia and Americans come in there, that they are going to want to get jerked off?
Yeah. I feel like I let you down because I should have told you that I had heard that this was a thing. And granted, both of us got a bit caught with our pants down.
Yeah.
But literally. I feel like
I didn't have pants on.
I was aware that this was a possibility and I should have told you. I feel like I let you down.
Maybe. I'm not going to sugarcoat that one. You might have let me down there. Because I literally.
So you had
no idea. No,
I
this was a hotel. This was a business. Like
it was a fancy ass hotel.
It was a fancy hotel. I really thought there was no possible way.
Okay.
Meanwhile, fucking the same fucking businessman from Milwaukee screams, "Just take the jerk, you queer."
Yeah, no.
This is the crossover moment.
But exactly.
Me, and if it was me now,
yeah.
Bachelor,
you know, like
gone through experiences.
Should have taken that jerk.
I may have.
Well, and plus also keep in mind the finale of the last time we told this story was Bonnie telling me you should have just taken the jerk.
You should have just done it. Okay, so she finishes up. She has like a different lotion that's more cooling for the finish, and you know, she rubs it all over, whatever. And then there is a moment of, would you like an ending? She didn't even say happy ending, if I remember correctly. It has been a few years, but it was a lot more mild. I think she got the idea.
That you were not comfortable with it.
I was not into it.
But she also knew it was her...
But she still kept doing it. So she asked me that, and I don't have to go through your pitch. I've heard the track. I don't have to go through the, like I'm nervous that, like, this is hush money thing. I'm just like, no.
Okay, first of all,
I don't want it.
No, when I was paying off my lady... And this is my one regret about the last time we told the track. To be clear, the most awkward part of that entire thing was me trying to pay boner hush money to this woman.
She's like, how much do you... No.
And taking money. Just go.
No.
So you didn't get taken for extra cash.
No. Okay. That experience never happened. Is where she said, do you want the happy ending? And I said, no. And then it was done. And I said, can I go take a shower? And she was like, yes.
Because I feel filthy.
Yeah, no. And I remember getting in that bathroom and just the water flowing over me. And I was done. I didn't even shampoo, wash, any the oil still all over me. I get dressed and I walk out and she's not there.
Yeah.
She had left. And then I walk past the front desk or whatever. And I go down to my other room and you hadn't come out yet.
Yeah.
You know,
that's because I was in the other shower jerking it.
Right. No. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So like, and then I get back to our hotel room And I get in the shower, and what was running through my head was I could do anything. Like, I'm Iron Man right now. Like, I've just gone through the experience of nightmares. Like, I could go to a nudist beach, fucking everything could hang out. Like, I don't care at all right now about anything.
So wait, for you, it was a purifying experience.
It was a little bit of a purifying experience for me. Because I really felt
so you've
after
done
that.
It. You've done it. So this was a little like boundary chicken for you, and you feel like you won.
I had gone through the gauntlet and survived, and it was absolutely that experience of like I had not experienced anything with any other people or whatever, and so it was like this crazy freaking like experience for me, and I just remember taking a shower and being like, "Wow, I've really crossed a ton of boundaries right now today." Like. Holy crap. And then I remember getting out of the shower and then like drying off, getting on clothes and walking into your room and be like, so Brian,
meanwhile, fucking Chad saunters in a tailored smoking jacket with a fucking like unfiltered camel and a snifter of brandy. And he's just like, hey, Bri, lots changed since fucking 2:30.
Yeah, and I was like, so how was your massage?
Hold on, I gotta remember it.
Oh my god! And you were like, we cannot tell Bonnie.
Oh shit! Oh, because that was your impulse the next morning, live on NSFW. You're like, oh, we forgot to talk about the awkward massage.
Oh, my,
I was like,
effing
dude,
god.
I'll be killed before yes. I allow this to be the way Bonnie finds out about
yes.
it. Jesus.
Yes. So that was my awkward massage. Wow. Was and like the baby monkey cannot be downplayed enough. That is you know, like cattle prodded into.
So
the
if any time you hear that song, that's immediately you're taken back to that moment.
Taken back to that that stonewashed massage room. Yes, absolutely. It's just like.
But you feel. I feel like you have like.
You know what I forgot?
What? What did you forget?
Was that the next, like, 2 days later, after we had been on air, the hotel called our room, and I picked up the phone. I was like, hi, you know.
Oh, because we were splitting a suite.
And we had just been on air, and they said, hello, we would like to offer you two free massage.
Oh, shit, son.
Really?
And I was like, what? Like, I knew what that meant. You were offering me sex for being on television. I knew that they were offering me free hand. The hotel offered us hand jobs because we were on television the day before.
Man.
My favorite food is pad thai.
My grandfather came here from a faraway place.
I one day wish to see New York.